हेलो स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ एट क्लास, दिस इज श्रुति। टुडे आई विल डिस्कस विद यू योर चैप्टर 2 ऑफ सिविक्स। योर चैप्टर इज अंडरस्टैंडिंग सेक्युलरिज्म। दिस इज वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग चैप्टर एंड यू हैव टू रीड योर चैप्टर वेरी वेरी डीपली एंड क्लियरली। ओके, लेट्स स्टार्ट योर चैप्टर। अकॉर्डिंग टू इंडिया यू विल हैव सो मैनी डाइवर्सिटी इन रिलीजन्स। ओके, देयर आर सो मैनी रिलीजन्स इन इंडिया। ओके, लाइक हिंदू, मुस्लिम, क्रिश्चियन, सिख्स, etc. सो मैनी रिलीजन्स इन इंडिया। ओके, एंड यू विल बी वन ऑफ दैम मेम्बर ऑफ दिस रिलीजन बिटवीन दिस रिलीजन्स। ओके, नाउ you know that according to Indian constitution you have the right to follow their personal religions according to personal choice. Okay, according to Indian constitutions all members of any religions okay have the fundamental right that protects against state power as well as against the tyranny of the majority. Okay, that is the secularism. Now your first topic is what is secularism. Okay, let's understand what is secularism. According to this para, the Indian constitutions allow individual the freedom to live by their religions, belief and practices as they interpret these. Okay, that means all persons of the Indian dominant have their right to follow their religions according to their personal rules. Okay, they can follow their religions as well as, okay, that is a secularism. Okay, and you also have the right to religion. Okay, right to religion, you also have this right. Okay, these acts of discrimination take place more easily when one religion is given officially recognition by the state at the expense of other religions. Okay, so now you have to understand only one thing. Secularism refers to the separation of religions from the state. Okay, that means religion should be separate from state. Okay, state should not interfere in religion and religion should not interfere for the state in state. Okay, these both things are different. Okay, according to secularism. Okay, but we have to understand Indian constitutions according to secularism. Okay, we have to understand Indian secularism. Okay, now the next topic is why it is it important to separate religion from the state. Okay, why should be separate religion from the state? Okay, a state should be separate from the religion. Okay, why? Because state should be a perfect state. Okay, that's why it should be separate from the religion, then state will be perfect state. Okay, then first importance will be when a importance will be for a country to function democratically. Okay, when a country want to function democratically, then should have to separate from the religions. Okay, like understand with an example. If you will read this para, you will find within these religions group, there will most likely be one group that is in a majority. Okay, if you are in democratic state, then one religion will be democratic. One religion will be in majority, and you know that is it is a democratic state. Okay, then what would have to do? Okay, if this majority religious group has access to state power, then it is could quite easily use this power and financial resource to discriminate against and persecute persons of other religions. Okay, then this religion will be a source of, what will be source of? Source of discrimination, source of coercion. Okay, and at the times even the killing of religion minorities. Okay, then minority persons can't follow their religions according to their rules. Okay, when a majority religion will dominate and will access power on the democratic state, okay, then a state should be separate from the religion. Okay, now you have got this point. Now tell me one thing, what is coercion? Coercion is a to force someone to do something. Okay, when you will force some other to do something with and force you, okay, that will be you are accessing your power on some other person. Okay, so you should not, that is coercion. Okay, second thing is that second importance will be for the freedom to interpret for religions. Okay, that means constitution allowed to interpret your religion according to yourself. Okay, but you should not interfere some others' religions. Okay, also you have this right. Okay, this is your second point for the importance. Okay, when you will explain with this para, you will get this point. Like, okay, I'll explain you in this para with this para. Okay, we also need to protect the freedom of individuals to access from the religions, embrace another religions, or have to freedom to interpret religions teachings differently. Okay, to understand this point better, let us take the practices of untouchability. There is an example of untouchability. Okay, you have got the what is untouchability. Okay, if you want to understand what is untouchability, you will have to watch previous video. Okay, for the lesson first. Okay, that was the chapter first video you will have to watch for the untouchability. Okay, I'll discuss with you two story in the next video. Okay, now you will have to read this chapter very carefully. Till stay home, stay safe, take care.